In the previous class, you have already learned how to make simple drawings. Now, you will learn some advanced features of paint window. Let us first revise a few things. Paint is a simple graphic program to draw pictures on the screen and paint them with beautiful colors. This is frequently called MS Paint or Paint. This program is a part of Windows accessories. It is a feature in the Windows OS that you can use to draw, color, and edit pictures. You can use paint like a digital sketch pad to make simple pictures or even to create creative projects. You can use paint to add text and designs to other pictures, such as those taken with your digital camera. There are tools to draw lines, rectangles, circles, and other shapes. Moreover, you can make freehand drawings. The best thing is that you can store the picture drawn in paint on a storage device. If you are working with a partner on a computer in lab, offer him or her the mouse and keyboard so that he or she can also add his or her creativity and you can make best drawing. Changing the outline style and fill style of the shape. You can select the outline style for the shape you are going to draw. It includes the thickness of line, the style of line, that is the medium for the shape outline, for example, natural pencil or solid color, crayon, watercolor or oil, etc. And also the fill style, that is the color and medium to fill the shape. If you don't want your shape to have an outline, then you can select no outline. You can also select a color to fill the shape before drawing. Once specified, these styles are applied to every ready-made shape. If you want to change the outline style or change the color of outline, do it before drawing the shape. Define your outline style. Select a shape in the shapes group and click outline. Several styles will be displayed. Select and click an outline style. If you don't want your shape to have an outline, click no outline. In the colors group, click color 1 and then click a color for the outline. In the colors group, click color 2 and then click a color to use to fill the shape. To change the fill style in the shapes group, click fill and then click a fill style. If you don't want your shape to be filled, click no fill. Draw the shape. You can do the same changes in the appearance of a shape after drawing until it is selected. Once deselected, no changes can be done. Let us try to draw some figures and color them by using the appropriate tool. Some tools and shapes such as the pencil, brush, line and curve lets you draw a variety of straight and curved lines. Drawing a curved line. You can use the curve tool to draw a smooth, curved line. On the Home tab in the Shapes group, click the Curve tool. Click Size and then select a line size, which determines the thickness of the line. In the Colors group, click Color 1. Click a color and then drag the pointer to draw the line. To draw with background color, right-click while you drag the pointer. After you have created the line, click the area in the picture where you want the arc of the curve to be, and then drag the pointer to adjust the curve. Painting with a brush. You can use the brushes tool to draw lines that have a different appearance. It is like using different artistic brushes. By using different brushes, you can draw free-form and curving lines that have different effects. On the Home tab, click the down arrow under Brushes. Click the artistic brush that you want to use. Click Size and then click a line size, which determines the thickness of the brush stroke. In the Colors group, click Color 1, click a color, and then drag the pointer to paint. To paint using the background color, right-click while you drag the pointer. Creating an airbrush effect. In the Brushes tool, click Airbrush. Select a spray size. Select the color to spray. To spray, hold down left mouse button and drag the mouse pointer over the image. Creating a watercolor effect. In the Brushes tool, click Watercolor Brush. Select a brush size. Select the color to draw. To draw, hold down left mouse button and drag the mouse pointer over the image. You can try different brushes to see how they work. Oil brush gives the effect of oil painting, and crayon brush gives effect as you are drawing with crayon colors. There are two calligraphy brushes, using which you can write text freehand or draw with a ribbon effect. The polygon tool. You can also make your own custom shape by using any polygon shape to draw a polygon. Polygon is a shape that can have any number of sides. A polygon having three sides is known as triangle. Having four sides is known as rectangle. And having five sides is known as pentagon. In the same way, a shape having six sides is known as hexagon. Use the polygon tool to make a custom shape with any number of sides. On the Home tab in the Shapes group, click the Polygon tool. To draw a polygon, drag the pointer to draw a straight line. Then, click each point where you want additional sides to appear. To create sides with 45-degree or 90-degree angles, press and hold the Shift key as you create each sides. Connect the last line to the first line to finish drawing the polygon and to close the shape. With the shape still selected, you can change the line style, size or color, and even the color to fill the shape. If the shape is deselected and you forgot to fill it, you can still do this using the Fill tool from the Tools group. When you are working on computer, save your work frequently. In case of power failure, your system may shut down and work may be deleted. Adding text. In Paint, you can also add your own text or message in your picture. The Text tool. On the Home tab in the Tools group, click the Text tool. Click or drag the pointer in the drawing area where you want to add text. Notice that a new tab named Text appears, displaying a variety of text tools in different groups. Under Text tool on the Text tab, click the Font Face, Size and Style in the Font group. In the Colors group, click Color 1 and then click a color for the text. Type the text that you want to add. If you want the background of the text area to be filled, click Opaque in the Background group. In the Colors group, click Color 2 and then click a background color for the text area. To save a drawing. Save your picture frequently so that you don't accidentally lose your work. To save, click the File tab and then click Save. You can also click on the Save icon in the Quick Access toolbar. This saves all of the changes made to the picture since the last time you saved. The very first time that you save a new picture, you will need to give your picture a file name. Follow these steps. Click the File tab and then click Save, or click on the Save icon in the Quick Access toolbar. A Save As dialog box to save a drawing appears. In the Save As type box, select the file format you want. In the File Name box, type a name and then click Save. Notice that the default file format is .png. Some other formats are .bmp, .jpeg and .gif. Next time when you work in the same file and save your drawing, it will not ask for the name, but will just save it. To open an existing drawing. If you want to work on an old drawing that you have saved, you must open it. Click the File tab and then click Open. Select the file name from the list of file names displayed in the Open dialog box, or type the file name in the File Name box. Click on the Open button. Your drawing is open in front of you, and you can make changes into it. Draw some more shapes or figures, change the colors, etc. Now try all these activities and have fun.